students, welcome to my channel Learning Hub. So agenda of this video is the return statement. We already finished arguments, types of arguments. Now we will learn about return statement. So return is a statement which decides the flow of control in any program. Well, suppose we have written a function and this function is called, suppose this function name is A and we are calling this function. And after this function is complete, the return will go to next statement. Means when we have called, the flow of execution will go, control will go to this function. After the last statement, the control will go to the next statement. But when we are using return, if we are using return statement, the control will go directly to the statement which has called the function. So return can return three types of things, that is identifier, literal and expression. So these three things can be returned by return statement. I'll take an example. Suppose this is a function sum, simple function to add two identifiers A and B. Suppose we want to add the two numbers and print C. So we have not used any return statement. So the program execution will start from here. It will make a function call. The control will go to this. And then execution after printing the value C. That is, output will be 5. And after this, the control will go to the next statement. So, because it is not returning anything, the functions which does not return anything are called as void functions. That is void functions. And the functions which returns something are known as non-void functions. So this is a common example, which is common question which is asked in board. What is the difference between void functions and non-void functions? So void functions are those which does not return anything, and non-void functions are those which returns an identifier or literal or any expression. So you can see here the same thing is there. Sum2 function is sum2, and after that you can see C is equal to A plus V. After then return is there. So when this function is called, after the return, the flow will go to the called function, means here only. Now, but we are not doing anything. After this return, we are not trying to print the returned value. It will return the sum. That is 6 plus 7, that is 13. It will return 13, but we have not used any print statement. So it is not going to do anything. So we have to use print statement to print the returned value. So in this case, when we are calling this function, so the control will go to this, and after the return, the control will go here. And the return value is 13, and 13 will go to print. It will print it on the screen. So output will be 13. One more thing, if we want, we can use, rather than print statement, we can have an identifier. Suppose x is equal to sum 2, 6, 7. In this case, whatever value it is returning, that is 13, that will be assigned to an identifier x. Now, x will contain the returned value, that is 13. One more thing, if we are trying to print, if we are trying to print a value which is not returned, in this case we are not using any return. So if here, rather than calling it directly, if we are trying to print sum 1, 2, 3, in this case it will print none. So in this case it will print none. Now the third function, that is sum 3, if we are calling this, it is, you can see it is returning the three values. We can return an identifier, we can return a literal, we can return an expression. In this case, what we can do, we can assign because it is returning something, we can use A comma B, or we can use suppose P comma Q comma R comma S is equal to sum 3, suppose 3 comma 5. In this case, when the interpreter will execute this, the sum 3 function will be called. The control will go to sum 3. What it is returning? A, B, A plus B and 2. So A will go to P, B will go to Q, A plus B will go to R, and 2 will go to S. So finally, if we will see, the P will contain 3, Q will contain 5, R will contain 8, and S will contain 2. So now if we want, we can print the value of P, Q, R and S. So I'll demonstrate this written statement on my laptop now.
So this is the program to demonstrate return statement. So the execution will start from here. First case, this first case will call the area rectangle. This is a function call. So as soon as this statement is executed, the control will go to area rectangle 1, this one. It will ask input from the user, length and breadth, and then calculate area and print the area. You can see the output. First, suppose 5 and 6. So area will be printed. Now, then after this, as there is no return statement, the control will go to this statement and it will print second case. You can see second case is print. You can see this second case is printed. After that, the next statement is print area rectangle 1. Again, it is calling this function and it will ask input from the user, print the area, and then control will go to the next statement. You can see, suppose length I am entering 6, breadth 8, and we are trying to we have used print statement. In this case, the area will be printed, but after that it will print none because it is not returning anything. When it is not returning anything and we are trying to use print statement with void function, in this case it will print none. You can see none here. Now we'll go to the third case, that is if there is a function called rectangle 2. This is a function, the same thing, it will print area, it will calculate area of a rectangle, and it is returning the area. When it is returning the area, but we have not used any print statement, so it is not going to print anything, means output will not be displayed and none will also be not printed because it is actually returning something, but we are not trying to access that. So you can see here, third, suppose 8. Suppose 8, breadth suppose 9, you can see it is not printing anything. Now, next thing is fourth case. In fourth case, what we are doing? We are using print statement. You can see here, we are using print statement. So whatever it is returning, that will be printed. This is written in inverted commas, that is printed as it is on the screen, that is area will be printed. And after that, whatever value it is returning, that will be printed. So length is suppose 5, breadth is suppose 2, area will be 10, and 10 should be printed. You can see area is equal to 10 will be printed. In the last case, what we are doing, that we are taking first, we are calling the function and we are assigning the return value to these three variables, that is length will go to L, breadth will go to B, and area will go to area. As you can see, L, B and area, it is calculating and returning all the three things. So you can see here, length is suppose 8, breadth is suppose 9, so it will print it's not visible. I'll just run it again. And this is, I'll just put inverted commas here. This is coming now. Again, I'll run this. So you can see length, suppose 5, 6, and it will print length 5, breadth 6, and area 30. Because it has returned length, breadth, and area, and that will be assigned to L, B, and area.
So, my dear students, I hope you understood the concept. If you like this video, please like and subscribe and hit the bell icon. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.